Hey there guys, welcome to Dino's Vault once again. Eid Mubarak to all of you out there, and may the joy and peace fill each and every home, and let peace rule this world. That's what we wish for this Eid. And I am setting out from my place to wish my fellow friends out there, and let's see how things turn out. And this is going to be my third vlog, I believe. Let's make something constructive out of it. That's what I thought. So I'm going to share about some safe riding tips as well as braking tips in this video. So I guess it's time to hit the road and let's see how things turn out. So here I am riding to Zuhair's place. Today I'm going to give you some very important tips about riding safely and staying out of harm's way. Towards the end of the video, I'll also share about braking techniques on a non-ABS motorcycle that can reduce the scope of wheel lock, thereby avoiding a crash. Now, we have some very powerful bikes being made available at affordable prices in our market. Even the biking culture like long distance touring and track racing is well and truly catching up with the youth of this generation. As such, I believe it is all the more important for the young kids to know how to control their mean machines. So through the course of this video, I'll talk about some very basic but very effective safe riding tips and braking tips that can eventually end up saving your life as well as someone else's life on any given day. Now, please note, I don't consider myself an expert. I'm just sharing what I have observed and learned over the past decade and a half as a biker. So without further ado, let's get started. Now I list them out point wise for you such that you can remember them more easily. First and foremost is wearing good riding gear, which starts with a good quality helmet. We end up spending thousands of rupees just for entertainment and junk food. But when it comes to helmets, we start thinking whether it is okay to spend around 5 to 10K on a helmet. That 5 to 10K might feel a bit expensive for a helmet, but trust me, that same amount can be counted as nothing when we realize the fact that the helmet is going to be a lifesaver for you and your family. Losing a life not just affects the individual but also the entire family. Therefore, buying a good quality helmet is necessary. It's even more necessary when you are married and have a kid. Point number two is to buy good quality gloves and a jacket. Now, wearing a jacket always might not work out practically, but at least make it a habit to wear your gloves even for your daily commutes. The reason I emphasize on that is because when we crash, the first thing we land on is our hands, and the gloves protect our hands from scraping off, so they do play a very important role. Point number three is when going out on tours, do wear a good quality jacket with adequate padding all around, because we never know what's going to happen next. It's always better to be prepared for the worst. Point number four is while riding on tarmac, I've noticed several times that the gravel on tarmac is really deadly. Slow down when you see sand or gravel on tarmac because the likelihood of bike skidding is really, really high. We can see here the sand or gravel on the road, and what's even more dangerous here is that it is right at the corner. So anyone trying to corner like Rossi are going to get a face full of tarmac. So please be watchful of such patches on the road and slow down immediately until you go past such patches. Now looks like we have some old ladies here hoping for some help. A little charity on any day would be an added blessing, I guess. Well, people argue that we shouldn't encourage such people by offering money, but I believe if we keep thinking in that direction, we can never really help people out. Sometimes you just need to go with what your gut feeling says, I guess. Now, one biryani or pizza worth of money that we might spend for ourselves can mean to them at least 2 to 3 meals. So no offense meant, please. That's just my way of thinking. Now, getting back to the points, point number five is blind turns. Now, blind turns such as these are very, very dangerous. We have no clue who or what is coming from the other side. So it is mandatory for us to slow down. This is also an accident prone area. We have boards up here. So please slow down in either of such scenarios because the likelihood of uncertainty is very, very high. Point number six is rear view mirrors. Now you might immediately find fault with me stating that I don't have rear view mirrors installed on my bike. I mean, it's sad, but that's the human tendency. We never look at the good, but focus more on the bad and finding faults with others. I'm a very straightforward guy, folks. I don't like to fake things or put up a show just to impress you. I prefer to ride without rear view mirrors because I ride mostly within city limits, and steering through traffic with rear view mirrors on isn't easy. There's every likelihood that I'm going to bump into others while steering through the traffic. Also, I don't do fast lane changes or drastic lane changes, so it works out okay for me. On highways, I very strongly recommend rearview mirrors because we never know who's going to whiz past you at what moment. Now, though I don't have the mirrors on my bike, I would humbly suggest that you have them on your bike even while riding through the city. Now, point number 7 is to slow down at intersections. While the exhilarating power some of the bikes offer these days, we tend to get carried away by them and would like to simply blast through the streets. The likelihood of someone showing up out of nowhere when we have intersections in between is really high. So please slow down near intersections as well. Now, you might be wondering if we have to slow down almost everywhere. So where do we have all the fun? Well, nowadays, companies themselves are arranging track days, which is the perfect setting to push the bike and yourself to the limit. Also, on the highways and toll roads where there are no intersections and the roads are a lot smoother, I believe we can have some fun to some extent. And point number 8 is not to make sudden lane changes. First, we need to avoid making sudden lane changes because we never know who's trying to overtake you from behind. Rearview mirrors do come in handy in such cases. Although relying completely on rearview mirrors too is not good. I myself have noticed several blind spots when I had my rearview mirrors on. I thought there was no one behind me, but eventually there was a person right next to me who wasn't appearing in the mirror. So beware of such blind spots that might mislead you. Also watch out for sudden lane changes the vehicles in front of you might do. Now, predicting this comes with experience, but it is always good to stay alert because even a momentary lapse in concentration can lead to a crash. Now, point number 9 is to slow down near signals. Now, when we see the green light, we tend to go at blazing speed just to cross the signal before it changes back to orange or red. But trust me, it is better we slow down because even these signals themselves are a bit cranky. They are green when we are crossing them and halfway through suddenly it turns to orange. And if the CCTV camera takes a shot, then we have to end up paying a challan. I had one such strange instance myself, so it is better to slow down. Also, the guys from the other corners of the signals are always raring to go. Some of them are so mindless that they are trying to have a head start even before the signal turns green. So such persons can even end up crashing into your bike. So it is always better to slow down when you're approaching a signal. And arriving 60 to 90 seconds late shouldn't be a problem, I guess, when compared to never arriving at all. Now I'll talk about the remaining points later on in this video. I've just reached Zoe's place. Zoher's dog Lexi should be somewhere here. So let's just tap the gate. And she should show up anytime now. And there she is. Lexi is a very friendly dog. Looks like she already recognized me. Okay, let's call up Zoher now. Zoher Ahmed is a well-known name in the motovlogging scene here in Hyderabad. And there he is.
Hello, 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 hello. How are you?
Bless you.
Thank you, thank you. Bilkul thik. Come in.
So here is Zoher's fleet of vehicles, his custom modified ER6N, then we have his all new Navi, the very definition of having fun on the run. Also here is his brand new Polo TDI. If possible, I'll try and get an ownership review done with him later on when time permits. So here I am at my best buddy's place, my biker brother and fellow YouTuber Zoher Ahmed, and I've been offered this sheer kurma. This is a delicacy that is served during the auspicious occasion of Eid. And it's been a long time because during my college days and my work days, I used to go and visit my friends' places. But now with this work schedule and everything, it was a bit hectic. Today, I made it a point to wish all my friends, and Zoher is the first place I've showed up. I have to meet three or four more friends on the way back. So let's taste the traditional sheer kurma. We have all the cashews and pistachios and the almonds, and we have it's drenched in ghee, so it's really rich. It's absolutely amazing. It's not too heavy. The consistency is just about perfect, and looks like we are good to start out a food channel as well. But it's really amazing. The sweetness is just about perfect. And I'm going to relish this, guys. So carry on. So after wishing Zoe, I'm next headed to meet Mr. Fayaz, who's also a diehard biker, an avid tourer, and also a YouTuber. So while I am riding to his place, let's quickly wrap up the rest of the points. Please do watch till the end of the video because that's where I talk about the crucial braking tips for a non-ABS bike. Now, point number 10 is to never take your eyes off the road. This is the most important and golden rule when it comes to road safety. The likelihood of anything happening in a matter of a few seconds is as high as the sky when you take your eyes off the road. No matter how luring a poster is, no matter how attractive a person appears, no matter how important a call might be, never ever take your eyes off the road while you are riding. If it is so important, you might as well stop aside and take the call, but never try to use your phone while riding. The area where keeping your eyes on the road really helps is it gives that extra reaction time, those precious extra seconds to take a split second decision. In case you have taken your eyes off the road, you are almost riding blindfolded. It's almost as if you have no clue what is going to hit you next, and the reaction time is almost reduced to 0 seconds. So that's the reason why I request you to completely stay focused on what's happening on the road right in front of you rather than looking elsewhere. Now, point number 11 is tire pressure. Now, this is a very important point which most of us miss out. The likelihood of the bike skidding is really high when we don't maintain the recommended tire pressure as mentioned in the user manual. The problem is most of us don't even read the manual. If you haven't, I would suggest you do that immediately. It'll hardly take you an hour or so for you to go through it, but I can assure you it would help you understand your bike a lot better. For instance, the tire pressure for my FZ version 2.0 as per the manual is 29 psi for the front tire and 33 psi for the rear tire. If you think it is too less to ride with a pillion on board, then just increase it by 2 to 3 points max, but not more than that. For my FZ, I maintain it at 30-35. And the harder the tire, the lesser are the chances of the tire gripping the surface. A softer tire can grip the surface better. So please maintain appropriate tire pressure such that you can avoid wheel lockup, which would result in the bike skidding. So hey there guys, and now I'm at my friend Fayaz's place, and I'm on this lift. It looks kind of spooky, and I'm going to wish him I'm here to wish him Eid Mubarak. And let's see, I hope he's there at his place. And that's about it. It's been a hectic day and I have one more friend to meet. So let's see how it goes. He is a YouTuber as well, and he is an avid tourer and a bike enthusiast. And he runs a channel called Fuzz Rides, I believe. So I'm here. So let's get out of this spooky lift. Okay. You can see how it looks. It can freak anyone out. Okay. So there you see Mr. Fayaz from Fuzz Rides, and I'm here to
please come
wish him. So the formality begin. Eid Mubarak bhai. So finally I made it. Okay. So I guess I need to chill out with my friend, so gotta cut out for the moment. Now, having wished Fayaz, I headed back home because my other two friends were both caught up with their relatives showing up at their place. Now, coming to the most important point of this video, that is the braking tips for a non-ABS bike. Now, please refer to my RTR 180 ABS review where I demonstrate how effective ABS with RLP truly is. You can also check out the Benelli 600i ABS video. So, please refer to those videos if you want to see how effective and how useful having ABS on board truly is. Now, please note that all of the aforementioned points are equally important and they do play a role while you have to brake suddenly, especially when you don't have ABS on board. And please try and have them at the back of your mind. Unfortunately, the bad habit most of us have when it comes to braking is that we end up using only the rear brake. Applying only the rear brake would lock the rear wheel, which would result in the bike skidding and you crashing. The same thing applies to the front wheel if we only end up using the front brake. Now, this is the reason why it is very important to apply both the brakes together. And this is the best option and best practice that you need to train your subconscious mind to do. Now, there are two points here as well. First is to apply both brakes together. And second is the amount of braking pressure you need to apply on the front as well as the rear brake simultaneously. As you can see in this video clip, I go up to speeds of around 50 kilometers per hour and I apply only the rear brake. As you can see clearly, the rear wheel locks up and the bike starts wobbling. Had I been doing higher speeds, I would have definitely ended up crashing. Now, next, I try taking the bike to similar speeds again of around 50 kilometers per hour, and I apply both the brakes at a time, I mean the front and the rear brake simultaneously. Now, you can see that I am coming to a standstill without locking up my rear wheel, and Honda are offering this as a feature named CBS or combi brake system, which more or less ensures that both the brakes are engaged simultaneously even if you end up applying only one of them. You need not pay that extra premium if only you can train your mind to apply both the front and rear brakes together at the same time. Now, coming to the braking pressure that needs to be applied on front and rear brakes while using them simultaneously, experts maintain that we need to apply 70% pressure on the front brake and around 30% pressure on the rear brake. Now, this applies mostly to street naked and super sport motorcycles as well as touring motorcycles. It may vary slightly for cruiser models. I also know it isn't possible for you to start calculating how much pressure you need to apply on each brake when you have hardly a matter of seconds to decide what to do next. However, I believe when you start applying brakes together and make it a habit, over a period of time, with experience, you'll start realizing and understanding how much pressure needs to be applied on each brake to come to a standstill in the shortest span of time. But the catch here is to apply a little more pressure on the front brake when compared to the rear brake when applying both of them together. So I'm afraid that's about it, guys. I just hope you found this video useful. Please share this video with your loved ones, boys and girls alike, because life is not a game where we can hit the restart button or play again button once we crash. So I just hope you found all the information that I've shared so far useful, and please share it with your friends. So until next time, this is Dino saying ciao, take care, God bless, and ride safe.